Hello dear masters, welcome to iTesla Solutions channel in partnership with CyberDoctor LLC. In the today video we have an iPhone XS logic board and we are going to do the reball to connect the and weld back because we have finished the solutions and we need to solder the logic boards back. So to the solder that we are going to use is 138 melting point. This solder is between QuickAlloy and the standard solder, which components are welded. So this is between two solders. And Apple uses to connect their sandwiched logic boards. It's a little bit old, I have kept it in the fridge. But I see that it have output a little bit hard. So in the today video I'm going to reball this logic board without any special tools. What we must to do is to solder each pad with such solder, and we must do this on both sides of logic boards, on the interposer each pad and on the application logic board. Also, if you have bent logic board, when you put them and there is a bend, most of times this side is a little bit upper. So what I am doing is I am bending it back, but you must do this very careful. I will show you which area is safe to bend. This area is safe to bend. Where is my needle? If you try to bend with your hands, and this stick is very important, application AI Pro, then you will say goodbye to your device. So when you try to bend in these places, this silicone IC chips, because the silicone is like glass, if you bend it breaks. So what I am doing is I put it on the silicone side, not sure if you will see. Wait, let me show you. Something like this. On the edge. And I push carefully as much I need. But don't force, because you can damage the watch board. So the idea is to put that middle on something like silicone, because silicone and silicone are different. The X are made of silicone, but this silicone pad is made of silicone, so you must search the internet to find the difference, to understand the differences between different elements of which everything is made in our world. Okay. So turn on your soldering iron at the brass tip from CyberDoc LLC. I will give it 300 of temp. If it will be not enough, I will lift it up. So let the soldering iron warm up and you can begin to add flux, because flux will be essential.
And how does that work? Make sure to not add a lot of it. But even if you add a lot, nothing bad will happen. Better I will add as I work. So I will talk less now and proceed. Also, I will not clean the wall to solder because it's basically almost the same.
It seems there is not enough temperature, so I am lifting to 350. I will try to lift the temperature to 400 because I don't like that I must add a lot of flux. Also make sure to solder the inside pads, I mean that goes to the component, then the edge pads. The soldering iron does not have a proper shape. Downgrade the temperature. So 350. Of course I added a lot of flux because my flux is very liquid. There are other more solidified types of flux that contain rosin. You cannot use those, they will not flow like that to the components.
Also don't forget that you are free to use a stencil special made for each iPhone logic board. So you are free to use such type. Do not play like me, but I am just showing you this method that I am using from iPhone old models. When I remember, I was doing this method on iPhone 3G to the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module. At that time you could not find easy stencils.
Okay, done. So what we'll do now? We will throw the logic board into the solvent and let it there to clean until we will do the interposer connector.
I had to stop the camera because the time it was ending. It can record only 27 minutes. Okay, add flux. In fact, I think you can do this only to the interposer and on the application to clean the logic board from the solder on the pads. Why? Because those pads that we make in this way are really big. I think they are bigger than with if you make with the stencil. And I think on interposer it's easier to make them, you will see. So I hope it will be useful for you, this method. Of course, many technicians, which do every day, they don't play with this method, but they know about this method. So I want to show how I do my way. When you add flux to the interposer, if you are careful, it does not flow to the logic board components. That is why it's possible. Better to do it on the interposer only. And this flux will can be left, so it will help with the connection.
As I told you, it's easier to do this on the interposer side. So I understand why it's easier to make on interposer. If you look careful, the flux stay in the same place. It does not flow to the other side. That's why it makes easier on the interposer. So the reason is flux. Okay, I have left.
Now let's do some cleaning. Because I need to see if all the pads are round. First I will take out that logic board. Second fold. My advice when you work on the application logic board, make sure you have logic board holder, which is specially made for each module, because any bending will cause to not weld all the pads. I will not add flux to this application logic board. I will add only on interposer. some parts didn't melt well and didn't became round. So I think I will have to fix them. Because they only are a couple. Okay, I will not clean this flux because it cannot to lubricate the pads on the application washboard. Of course, I will look. Okay, I don't see bending. If there is, it's very small. Now is the most challenging part. The alignment of this logic board. And if you don't have special logic board holder, you will have to play.
So fucking yeah. I think the only thing I need to look is from the top.
This is the most challenging because if you fuck it, you will fuck it. But all your work will be fucked. Okay, I have three magnets. I will place them on the three sides. And it will align it to the interposer. The application will work and will push from the seam side. Then will hit, and I think in this way. Wait a minute. In this way, it will help to align.
Okay. So I will keep in this position and hit. I hope it works. If not, then I am crazy. Technician. So I will give 230 of temp full airflow. I hope it works.
On some parts, so what I do now, I will fucking take this out. Careful and hit faster. Let's see if there is not some mess. Okay, as you can see, not all balls melted. So the position is correct. Okay, let's go faster with my craziness. And keep the logic board. I have 6 minutes. And I will look careful. Yeah. What I can say, dear masters? It worked. Yes, the balls are very big. I see that it on the seam yet, it did not solve that fine. Maybe there is too much ground. The logic board is lifted on the side. Yes, I see there is not enough gem, so I will hit on gems again. And hope to end the video. I will give 335 and hit it again on gems.
I will see to clean the flux so we see if the balls are fine. The logic board is still hot. What I can say that yes, I was right. The balls look bigger, are bigger than when it come from factory, because I can see the baseband parts. So yes, if you want, you can just revolve the interposer, because that's how Chinese make, only for interposer, the reballing stencil. But if you do my method, it can be even easier. So as we can see, we see the balls, and all of them seems to be melted. So that's it, guys. Please like, share, subscribe, spread the word, and join our website Tesla Solutions, and go buy something from CyberDoc LLC. I hope you have enjoyed. Have a good day. Bye.